Hi, and welcome to another episode of Cloud in 5 Minutes. Today, I want to talk to you about Azure Function Proxies and show you some tricks that I do with it. Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de cette vidéo. Vous avez seulement qu'à cliquer sur le lien qui apparaîtra dans le coin au droit de votre écran. Again, let me introduce myself. So I'm Frank Boucher, Microsoft Azure MVP based at Montreal. Today, I want to take a few minutes to show you what we can do or what I do with Azure Function Proxy. Let's do it. So I'm already in the Azure portal and I created a function app. Now I was waiting for you guys to create a custom functions. In today's example, I will create an HTTP trigger, but we can use many different things. So HTTP trigger, and since I'm comfortable with C#, we'll use C#. So let's call it Frank Demo. Oops. So now the function is created and everything is okay. So I will click here to get the URL, and we note that I'm using security functions level, so I have the code. So I will use Postman. Ari praises many times Postman. If you don't know that tool, I invite you to download it. It's free. I will put the URL in the description of this video. So in Postman, I will just paste. So we note that code is passed. So I should already hit my function. Of course, it's complaining that I didn't pass the name. So let's add a name. So name and then Frank, and now I should get my hello. Perfect. It worked exactly as expected. Now let's add a proxy. So back in the Azure portal, the proxies are just here under the functions, and to create a new one, I click the plus button. So I will give it a name, salutation, and then I will put a root. Salutation again, and for my backend URL, I will use the function URL I just created. So let's create that. So we see now the proxy has its own URL, and if I try to use it, let's use this button, and I go in Postman, and I paste this URL. We note that I'm not passing the security code right now. But if I send it, I already hit my function. Why? Because the proxy is taking care of that. So it could be very useful if you want to manage some parameters. You know, you could give different URL to your clients and they could use different proxy, and then the proxy will integrate some feature and pass it to the function. But it will still work for any other parameter. So if I add my name in it, it will still work perfectly. Hello, Frank. Cool. So now we have a proxy, and one thing that could be interesting if what else can we do and where all that information is saved. So in fact, guys, all this information is a big JSON file, and you can it go, well, I did it quickly, so let's go back. So here in the right top right corner, we have the advanced editor. And if I go there, this is our JSON. Pretty cool. So one thing that I do really often, instead of having this domain name that come over and over, I just use a variable settings that I have in my app settings of my functions. And by enclosing it with the percent symbol, then it's a way to specify to Azure Function to go check in my application settings. Let's have a quick look. So if I go back here, then I can go here, and I will have my application settings just here. So I click, then if I scroll, I see that I configure already a host name, and I put my host name here. That's nice, right? So now if I hit again, it will still work without any problem. And by the way, this file is automatically saved, so I don't need to save it. You will see the status in the top right corner. Let's go a little bit further and add a fake proxy. I'll just move that. Oops. this is what I want to do. Okay, so for this proxy, the match condition will be fake. And what I do is I override completely the response. So I don't care about any function. It's just like I will generate my own result. So let's try this. So see, it's saved. So I will go in Postman and I will create, let's take this thing. And then I'll go here and I will change the salutation by fake. And if I click send, it doesn't care about my name or anything because it doesn't hit any functions. So it will be very, very useful if you're trying to mock, to do some mocking and test your APIs or functions. Now you have a way to not even hit your functions, but just like return whatever you want. And be sure to test all your scenarios. Okay, let's go one thing further. A thing that I will probably use in a new website that I'm building for a cloud in 5 minutes. Okay, so let's add another proxy. This one is static5. So the match condition that is the method get, and I'm rooting root. And then I pass using the same technique that I show you before, the blob URL pointing to an HTML file that I put in my blob storage. So what happened if, so it's saved. So what happened if I go in Postman and I use this thing? Yep. So I'm using the get and then I point to the root of my function and I get HTML code. And if I go in a browser and I try this, then I will see the result. This is really useful and it's also fun because now, since I can put a domain name to my functions, I could clearly have like cloudin5minutes.com pointing to this and also have some functions helping me in my static website. We know that, you know, Azure storage is really cheap. So now we could have like a little website running over there and it will be a very cheap version. So that's it. In a few minutes, I showed you how it was easy to use the function proxy in your dev and test. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful. I'm very curious. Let me know how you use the function app proxy in the comment below. Here are two suggestions of video. The one on top is another video where I talk about Azure Function. The one below is another great video from Cloud in 5 Minutes. Thanks for watching. See you next time.